So in this lab, we're going to focus on OpenVPN. So OpenVPN is a virtual private network solution. It is flexible, reliable, and secure, and it belongs to family of SSL TLS VPN stack. So what we are doing, we have two machines here. One of them is Linux 1, Linux 2. So first thing, you should configure your network configuration. So this one is part of VMnet 19. That's okay. And the second one also should be part of VM 19. It has two network interfaces. You can only have one network interface. So I'm gonna delete one of them. So not so. Then you have two network and like one network interface on Linux 1 and the other one on the Linux 2. So the thing is that you log in with the Linux 1 and we set the IP configuration here. So I'm gonna do here on the wire setting. So if you look at the document, it says that Linux 1 should be 192.168.1.10. That's it. And you can put the gateway as 192.168.1.1, but it's not mandatory to put 1.1. You can just leave it at 192.168.1.10 and 255.255.255.0. Leave blank the gateway. So that's okay for this step. And Linux 2 also should be, if you check the Linux 2, this one should be 192.168.1.1. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go on the wire settings and here IPv4 settings. So this is also 1.1. So IP configuration is correct for this lab. And probably if you open, the terminal here. So if you open the terminal, then let me also zoom in. So sudo dash s, you should have a ping of 192.168.1.1. I do have. So that means that you can ping Linux 2. So that's the prerequisite for this lab. That means that you have basic configuration of networking. You can ping, and Linux 1 and Linux 2 have the IP addresses based on the document. So then what you do, you create a share key in the Linux 1 and share this key with the Linux 2. So I'm gonna create a share key here. So open VPN. So you type here open VPN and then dash dash gen key and then secret. So that's the name of the key that I'm creating here. I put it mykey.key. So look now, you have mykey.key here. So how does it look like if you cat my key.key? It is like the key that you have. Basically, this is like a symmetric encryption. It means that you have one key and you're sharing that key with the other operating system. So what I'm gonna do now, I do scp my key.key and I copy this key to Linux 2. The IP address of the Linux 2 is 192.168.1.1. The user is Ubuntu. @192.168.1.1. So you can put it, look, if you look at here, for example, if I open terminal also here, this is Linux 2, right? So if you do sudo dash s here, look, I can put it under this folder /home/ubuntu. So you can add here /home/ubuntu. right? We don't have port 22. Basically, maybe, let me see the SSH configuration here. Nano etc SSH SSHD.conf. Yeah, SSH.
You changed that to 2222, right? Config.
Yeah. Sorry. So nano etc SSH. So you remember that? We changed this one in the previous session to SSHD underline config. So I changed this one to 2222. So I'm gonna bring it back to default port. So that was for the last video that we had. And then you service SSH restart. So if you do service SSH status, here, look, it's saying that now it is listened to port 22. So we fixed the issue. So now port 22 is enabled. So you know that SCP also by default is using port 22. So now if you do it again, this one on Linux one, so it's asking for fingerprint, you're saying yes, and then that's it. So you copy the my key, that key on there, 192.168.1.1. So let's go to here, ls, my key, that key is here. So you see that? We copy that one. So then under Linux 2, you should create also a server.conf file. So you can do it like this, server. .conf. Be careful that this file and the server.conf file should be in the same folder. So we are putting them in the same directory. So we create a device tunnel. And then if config, that's the IP address for a tunnel that you're assigning. For example, I am assigning IP address for local to 1.1.1.1. To the remote one, the peer one, I put it as 1.1.1.2. And then I'm gonna say here that okay, my secret key is my key.key. That file that I copied here. And I save it. So now in Linux 2, if you do OpenVPN --config. And then server.conf, you should have this result. That means that it's waiting for local. So we come back to Linux one. And under Linux one, we do the same thing because we have here, if you do ls, we have mykey.key. So here, and then you create the kind of file, we call that one as a client.conf. That's a configuration for client. So then here we are saying now, okay, our remote IP address is 192.168.1.1. And then device tunnel, that you create a tunnel. So this time when you're writing the IP address, you're saying that the local IP address is 12. And the remote one is 1.1.1.1. And then last one, secret, is my key.key. Okay, so save it. Then if you do now OpenVPN --config and then client. .conf. So you see that it's trying. You see that here. The tunnel is up, and then you created peer connection between an initialization completed. So that's like a peer-to-peer connection between this Linux and this one. So it's like a VPN between a tunnel between Linux 1 and Linux 2. So that's it for OpenVPN.